Hi there. Welcome to this session on browser isolation using Application Guard for Microsoft Edge, a way to implement security without compromising on productivity. My name is Arunesh Chandra. I'm a security product manager on the Edge team. So by the end of the session, you should be able to discuss the value of browser isolation as a security strategy for your organization, and hopefully we'll cover enough details for you to be able to try out Application Guard to achieve browser isolation in your own organizations. All right, I'm sure we have all seen these scary headlines like these. It's hard to miss. Security breaches are commonplace these days and a fact of life almost. The good guys have to always be a step ahead in the game. No matter how many security threats you have blocked or thwarted, bad guys have to succeed only once in your organization to strike gold. These breaches are costly to recover from. $3.86 million is the average cost to recover from a breach. Apart from the financial loss, the company loses trust and reputation in the marketplace. It loses customers and impacts business. As we all know, humans are the weakest link in securing a digital perimeter of any organization. A sustained and sophisticated effort can sometimes compromise even the best of us. So to understand how humans impact the security of your organization, we need to understand where these humans are spending time on your network. Yes, it is inside the browser. 60% of the time spent on a PC is on the web. So basically, PCs are browsing machines. And that's the reason why desktop browser remains the primary attack surface on a client device inside the enterprise today. Number one, because that's where the humans are. And number two, because the primary job of a browser is to allow access and download and execute untrusted content from untrusted sources. And this makes the browser an easy and a ripe target to the attackers who are constantly working to engineer new ways to attack the browser and sometimes social engineering new ways to attack the user. And the challenge the enterprise admins and SecOps face is to figure out how to balance security needs without sacrificing productivity. Allowing unrestricted access to browsing the open internet obviously has risks to the corporate network. And restricting access to only a list of approved sites has its own downside of productivity for users. Users needing access to a blocked website for some reason will have to go through a process and it delays their the job that they're trying to get done. It's a hard balance to strike, no doubt. There's a growing trend among enterprises today to deploy something called Assume Breach Principle as a security strategy. This strategy states that there is an acceptance that an attack is going to succeed at least once, regardless of the efforts to prevent it. This mindset requires building defenses to contain the blast radius to limit the damage in case of a breach. And that's where the browser isolation comes in. Browser isolation is a security model that aims to protect enterprise network and devices by physically isolating away the end user's browsing activity and its associated risks. And even Gartner has started recommending this solution to the enterprise, saying browser isolation technologies are one of the most effective ways that an enterprise can reduce web-based attacks. So there are two types of browser isolation, the client-side isolation and a server-side isolation. On the client side, there are technologies that utilize the end user device by configuring the hypervisor and firewall rules in order to achieve the isolation it needs. On the server isolation, which is also called remote browser isolation, the isolation is delivered to the user's browser through a SaaS service. It makes it more expensive because the SaaS services are, you have to pay by per user, usage counters are there. So compared to a client-side solution, server-side solution is slightly expensive. And this is where Application Guard comes in for Edge. It's a client-side browser isolation. It moves the browser session to an isolated virtualized container on the device while protecting the corporate network from breach via the untrusted sites. And this provides a significantly increased protection on to the browser, which is the favorite device, application the attacker is trying to target. So Application Guard is based on a hypervisor-based kernel-level isolation. As you can see in the diagram here, on a single device, there are two separate kernel running with the full stack of OS and platform services up until the edge browser. This kind of isolation provides the most robust security in a browser scenario. This is supported natively in Edge. You can configure it in a variety of different ways. It will prevent persistence of an exploit even if it gets downloaded. And you can deploy this in two different ways, an enterprise managed mode and a standalone mode as well. It is supported with the new Edge browser from Windows 10, 18.09 and above on enterprise and professional SKU. It has a certain amount of system requirement with a 64-bit CPU, 8 gigs of RAM, and 5 gigs of free space on SSD drive recommended. So let me show you a quick demo. So this one is basically showing that somebody types in a bad URL accidentally, that it opens up in this isolated container. You can see that there are markings in the browser to show you that you're in a container. Here's another example of showing dynamic navigation. So you are inside a container, you type in a trusted site, which is an internal website. It brings you back to the host for that particular navigation. And you get SSO and every other feature that you expect in a normal browsing session will be available. Here's another use case where you are on your email, you're on a company email, you receive a personal email from your friend saying, hey, let's go for buying some camping gear for the weekend trip. And that is a personal navigation, not a corporate trusted site. It opens up in the container here again with a fully functional website, which is, if this were supposed to be a phishing attack, or if this site was supposed to be malicious in some way or was exploited unknowingly, anything that this site brings, it remains inside the container without impacting your corporate network. So Application Guard has a lot of policies that you can use to configure. And the first toggle is turn on and off. Then it has several policies that you can configure to enable clipboard operation one way or bidirectional. You can control printing from the container or not. You can allow data persistence for sometimes you would want the data to persist so that the users can save their cookie or the sign-in state and things like that. You can control whether you can allow download to host or not. You can control the camera, mic, and have a variety of different controls using these policies. So if you have worked with Application Guard in the past with the legacy Edge, there are some new things that we have added since then in the last year that we have brought the new Edge browser in the market. And while we worked on this, we were talking to customers who were using Application Guard, and we listened very closely to their feedback. And some of the things that we have heard that the users wanted was browser extension support inside the container. Customers also wanted Application Guard traffic identification. So whatever traffic is generated from the application guard container. People wanted to monitor that, apply some proxy rules so that, you know, the enterprise is still compliant with the device usage policies and stuff like that. We also heard from customers that diagnosing end user reported issue was sometimes a challenge. So we have built a diagnostic page for troubleshooting, and I'll show you demos of all this. And last but not least, the Legacy Edge, the browser was baked into the container and you only had one instance of the browser running in the container. But now with the new Edge browser, just like on the host, you can run side by side all the four channels of Edge browser. You can run the same side by side Edge channels on inside the container as well. And the Canary on the host will talk to Canary on the container. Stable on the host will talk to stable in the container. So let me show you some more demos. One of the first thing I want to show you is how to set up and configure. This is a way to kind of just get you understanding like what are the different pieces that that are needed. So I'm going to use the Microsoft Endpoint Manager, the console here, where we have to kind of build these device configuration policies. So there are two profiles we'll create. The first one is called the Endpoint Protection profile. So we'll go ahead and name this profile Application Guard. And then, you know, the first thing in the configuration setting, we'll see the Microsoft Defender Application Guard setting. Here you can turn on to enable it for Edge. And then you can see that there are a whole bunch of configuration settings like clipboard behavior, allowing copy from the PC to the container or blocking it altogether. So we'll select block at this time. You can control printing. You can control whether the persistence is there or not. The data can be saved in the container, or you can allow download of file or not. So you can configure all that. And like other, you know, and then you'll select, go ahead and apply to all devices. And just generally any kind of applicability rule. I'll skip that part for demo purpose here. And then, you know, you will have a dashboard where it will show you how the policies have been deployed or not and what is the coverage. The second profile we're going to create is the network boundary profile. So we'll go ahead and create that, give it a name, network boundary, and then we will get to the next page. This is where the most important configuration is needed. I will skip entering all those details here, but there's IPv4, IPv6, cloud resources, network domain, and neutral resources. Basically, these are the different types of configuration you can add, you know, values to here. And then that will define your trusted list of resources that are supposed to be open in inside the host. Anything not listed on those that list is going to be considered untrusted, and the navigation will be moved to the container. So now you can see these are the two different profiles you have to create and deploy, and that's how you deploy Application Guard. Next one I want to show is the support for this browser extension. So we are inside the container and you have visited a particular extension here, Microsoft Shopping Assistant, and we go ahead and add it. This was not possible in the legacy Edge browser. So this is a new thing that we have added based on the customer feedback saying they would like to allow extensions in the container. So this support is available now. The other ask we got was that users wanted to identify traffic coming out of the container to allow applying the proxy policies, you know, that the users are not going to sites that are prohibited in that jurisdiction or for the company policies. So even though these sites are coming are untrusted site or personal navigation space, but it's still it's on the company device and they wanted to enforce proxy policies there. So what we have added is an ability to configure another proxy configuration, which will be linked to the container. So the enterprise admins have access to applying the policies inside the container as well. Another thing we heard from the customer, as I said earlier, was ability to diagnose customer reported issues. So here, you know, we have an internal page inside a application guard window where you have a lot of machine related capabilities surfaced here. Sometimes, you know, the users are complaining that, hey, you know, this site I was supposed to, I was expecting it to run on in the host and it's running in the container. And what you do is, you know, you just make sure that you check whether the site is, what is the trust level of a site that the user is reporting issues with. And that sometimes, you know, resolves a lot of debugging that needs to happen. So by knowing that, oh, this site is untrusted, you can go and figure out what configuration needs to be done in order to fix that problem. And then there's a log tab here. It gives you all the activity the browser and the platform has done, and it quite helpful to kind of understand the timeline of a problem that is being reported. All right, so we've discussed all the things that we have worked on. So what's in the future? We've heard from the customers that who we are always listening to, that favorite sync in the container is a big deal for them. They want to make sure the host and device experience remains the same. So that's something we are working on. We've heard from them about the site list management being too hard, too cumbersome. So we're looking into improving the site list management experience. And also we are looking at isolated tabs. So instead of making the isolation available in a window, we want to bring that inside the tab of a host browser session. So that you should expect to hear from us about these pretty soon. So that was it. All the things that we talked about will be easily available for you to access at akams/msedgesecurity. So give it a try. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. I'm at Arunesh C on Twitter. I'll be happy to respond to any questions you might have. And yeah, stay safe out there. And thanks for listening. Bye.